Fire.
Hi guys, Napizon is here. Welcome to another episode, how to make the ace in World of Tanks. If you're not interested in making the ace, surely this will help you to perform better in the game. This time I picked the tier 4 Swedish tank destroyer, the Saw M43. Seeing the success of the German and Russian assault guns at the start of World War II, Sweden settled the production of the Saw M43 in September 1941. In the spring of 1946, this tank destroyer received the 105mm gun. 36 vehicles were produced and kept in service till 1973. So, let's go to the tactic to see the position of the Saw M43. To get the Saw M43, you will start with the PVLVV FM42 at tier 2, followed by the AKV72 at tier 3, who unlocks the way to the Saw M43 at tier 4. So, let's see how we're gonna upgrade this tank. We're gonna put the second pair of tracks with 32 travel speed, the last engine with 162 horsepower, the last radio with 455 meter signal range, and from these three guns we're gonna put the most accurate one. The 7.5 centimeter Canon M41. And look here guys, this gun has 107mm of penetration with the regular ammo, and that is AP, and it costs 66 credits per shell. 130mm of penetration with the gold round, and that is also AP, and it costs a lot, 2800 credits per shell. And 38mm of penetration with HE, and it costs 75 credits per shell, actually more than the regular ammo. The damage with the HE is 175, and with the AP is 110. Let's see now the DPM. As you can see, the DPM is not very good for a tier 4 tank destroyer, is only 1681. The gun depression is incredible good. Look here, minus 14 degrees. It's awesome. Elevation is 20. The aiming time is very good, 1.92. The accuracy is also not very good for a tank destroyer, is only 0.38. Let's see now the general stats. What we see here is calculated with the crew skills and equipment that we have on this tank. And because we talked about the Saw M43's gun in the upgrades, let's start this with the survivability. So, very standard hit points for a tier 4 tank destroyer, 270. Let's see now the armor. The hull. 50mm on the front, 15mm at the sides, and 15mm at the rear. Let's see now the mobility. It weighs 13 tons fully equipped. Engine power, like I said, 162. It gives 12.43 horsepower per ton. Actually not so bad. The top speed is okay for a tank destroyer, 43 kilometers per hour. The reverse speed is 20 kilometers per hour. And the traverse speed is only 33.31. Let's see now the concealment. It's very good for a tier 4 tank destroyer. Look here, 22.5 for a stationary vehicle and 13.5 for a moving one. And let's see now the spotting. View range, standard, around 300 meters. Signal range, standard, around 435 meters. Let's check now the SOM43's armor in the tanks, GG. So, let's see now the hull. Frontal plate, 50mm. Angled, 53. Lower plate, 15mm. Angled, 16mm. The upper plate, 35. Angled, 36. The sides, 15. The sides of the superstructure is only 13. Let's see now the superstructure on the front. 51. Angled, 57. Commander's hatch, only 13. So as you can see, the SOM43 has no effective armor whatsoever. Let's go back to the garage. So the first step after upgrading the tank is the crew skills. The SOM43 has a crew of 4 members. The commander, the gunner, the driver and the loader. The commander is also the radio operator. So the 2 most important skills in the game are Sixth Sense and Brothers in Arms. Although this is a tier 4 tank, and let's face it, when you reach tier 4 you don't have any crew skills whatsoever. I use my Swedish woman crew, the one that I received during the holiday season, because I didn't use this tank with enough equipment and the top modules. So, the commander has Sisterhood of Steel and Sixth Sense. The gunner, Sisterhood of Steel and Dead Eye. The driver, Sisterhood of Steel and Off-Road Driving. And the loader, Sisterhood of Steel and Safe Storage. I didn't mention the third skill because it's on 0%. The second step is the equipment. And we're gonna put the binocular telescope that gives plus 25% view range active when the vehicle is stationary. Don't forget this. The camouflage net, active when the vehicle is stationary, and the gun rammer for faster reload. The third step is the consumables, which are small repair kit and small first aid kit. So, with these combinations you have to make the ace. Let's see this tank in action. Welcome to the replay. The map is fiery salient. And as you can see, I'm top tier. This map is a very good map for tank destroyers. In this replay, I used the stock SOM43 because I didn't have enough free experience to research the top modules. I also didn't have enough credits for the gun rammer. I used only binos. The penetration with the regular ammo of the stock gun is 63 and with the gold ammo is 115. This is my second game with the SOM43. I used to carry 41 regular ammo, 16 gold and 3 HE. That is a total of 60 rounds and 6795 damage. So running out of ammunition is not a problem. I don't have enough equipment and the top modules on this tank, so I used my Swedish woman crew, which I received during the holiday season. So, I have Sixth Sense and Sisterhood of Steel to engage in this battle. And that is more than enough to play well with this tank. As you can see, I don't have the painting on this tank either, because the SOM43 has a very, very good camo rating. I see the enemy SOM43 in the middle of the map. And as you can see, the 0.4 accuracy of my tank didn't allow me to shoot him. I don't know why he attacked alone in the middle. That was foolish. He didn't accomplish anything. He didn't even spot me or the rest of my team. You will see in this replay that we are actually only 14 members in this team, because one of the AKV-72 is AFK or bot from the beginning of this game. My team started advancing in the G2 line. We are now waiting their attack. I'm pretty sure there is an enemy tank hiding in the D1 bush. That's why you saw me blind firing. So the enemy is coming. The Type 95 and the Valentine 2. The Type 95 is dead. And the Marder 3080 was spotted too. My instinct was right. There is an enemy tank after all in the D1 bush. The Hetzer. The Hetzer has 60mm frontal armor, but it is beautiful sloped. So the 63mm of penetration of the stock, so M43's gun is not enough. That's why I switched on the gold round with 115mm of penetration. I see the Valentine too. Look how the shell went. But damage is damage. So the little ugly duck AMX-40 is approaching with his 70mm sloped frontal armor. Let's pull back to keep the distance from the enemy. And I reposition myself in the H1 line. As you can see, the Saw M43 is a little bit sluggish, but it is okay for a tank destroyer. Come on. My team killed the AMX-40. I was spotted for the first time in this game. It must be that Hetzer in the D1 bush. Let's pull back. Artie just missed me. Let's avoid the Artie. I'm changing position again. You see now the bot AKV-72 camping at the base from the start of this game. Honestly, I have the urge to shoot him, but I don't want to be banned. Wargaming has to do something to punish these kind of players, as they did with those who cheated. This is my opinion, of course. Because of the stock radio, you may have the impression that I lost my other teammates, like the Marder 38 team. And I just find the STRV M40L, the tier 3 tank destroyer, who has just been killed. As you can see, I just made radio contact with the Marder 38T. He is in the A6 position. Being in the middle, I have knowledge about all my teammates. That Hetzer, it hasn't moved from there since the beginning of this game. Oh, sorry, he moved from D1 to E1. My arty finished him. Now, that bot, AKV-72, is helping me with the spotting. Although he is AFK, his tank gives me the intelligence of that part of the map, spotting the enemy medium 3. So I'm going back to our base to encounter the medium 3. Who is probably gonna cap. A blind shot, but I don't think that I hit him. Let's move forward. I was right. He started to cap. Now we are behind with two tanks. With one tank. Finally I spot him. I can't believe that I missed. I missed again. 3rd is my lucky number. And my arty finished him. Now we are even. 11 at 11. Although I didn't put my mark on this game, I now have the opportunity to win. Let's see what happened. First, we lost two tanks. Let's move forward. I will try to use the fantastic gun depression of this tank, and that is minus 14 degrees. I see the arty. One, he missed me. The AKV-72 is also attacked me. Look here, the gun depression. So, I killed him first, but I receive a massive hit. I put back my dead gunner, and let's change position once again. Thank you for following me. And this is my second kill of the game. The STRVM-40L wants a piece of me. Arty missed me again, so I'm feeling lucky today. Look at the fantastic minus 14 degrees of gun depression. Come on. Oh boy, that shell. Let's trade. One. Two. Angling. And this is my third kill of the game. My hearty appreciates what I accomplished here. He said on the chat, nice job. Thanks, mate. I know the last position of the enemy arty, but maybe he moved. Let's see if he's still there. So I'm using these bushes to stay hidden. Time is running out. I have to find him and with a little bit of luck to kill him. I was spotted, so he's here. Blind shot. Oh boy, I see him after he shoots. Lucky me, he missed. Now is my turn. So one. And we win. I hope that I highlighted in this replay the fantastic gun depression and camo rating of this tank. Let's see now the post-game stats. So here's our mastery badge Ace Tanker. We got 2712 experience with the premium account, that was double. We managed to give only 942 damage. We picked up 4 kills and we received 904 basic experience. I like to play with this tank because it has an excellent gun depression and it has a very good camo for its tier. What about you guys? Do you like the Saw M43 or not? Please share your thoughts in a comment below. Thank you guys for watching, I hope you enjoyed this. Good luck on the battlefield and see you in the next episode.